So now, without further ado, I want to bring up our panel moderator and discussion leader for tonight, Steve Williams.
So good evening, everybody. As Joe said, this is promises to be a really inspiring and exciting evening. But first, I want to see a show of hands. How many people in this room have gotten a chance to work with either Steve or Pam throughout your activist career? Put your hands up high. There's no shame in having worked with either of them. So part of the reason why I wanted to start off that way is to sort of show the impact that Steve and Pam have had. I think it is very fitting that we're getting a chance to have this evening to both celebrate the work that you've done, but also to learn the lessons. Because in some very important ways, both Pam and Steve represent the best of what San Francisco is and the best of what San Francisco can be. And it's very clear that that's under attack in some very important ways. And I think it's very fitting for us to both acknowledge the work that you all have done, but also to commit ourselves to pick up the baton and to keep that work going forward. So I'm really excited to be here. I'm just excited to be a fly on the wall and sort of hear the conversation that's going to happen. But I also want to thank Hospitality House for letting me sort of moderate this, because I met both Pam and Steve basically like a block away from this particular building. I remember meeting Steve at the Coalition on Homelessness office at 126 Hyde Street, way back in the day when I had hair. And I met Pam for the first time at the Local 2 office, just across the street. And so I think it's very fitting that we're having this conversation here, because both of them have such important roots in this particular community. So, you know, to start this off, I wanted to introduce both Pam and Steve. But I think because of time, I'm more interested in hearing from them both about what's brought them to the movement. And I recognize that each of them have their own particular stories of experiences, perspectives that have brought you to this particular point in the struggle. So rather than me cataloging the long list of accomplishments and successes that both of them have had in their career, I'm going to give each of you an opportunity to talk about some of the work that you've done. So maybe starting with you, Pam, what are the things that brought you to be an activist in the movement?
Sure. Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity to be with you tonight. I'll do anything for the Hospitality House. I just really love this organization and the work that it does in the community. And so, with that, I want to be able to talk a little bit about my roots. I was born here in 1948 in San Francisco. My roots are in San Francisco, Chinatown. And the period in that 1940s was a period in which, you know, America was, you know, great and to be American and Americanization. And so I was born in a period where the pressure to assimilate and the pressure to reject your heritage and your culture was very, very deep. The roots in San Francisco Chinatown is very important for who and how I come to the movement, in that it's a space. It's a space of great resistance and resilience in those six blocks, with a strong history of family, community, and struggle. And so my situation with my family is that we grew up there. I'm fourth generation, and a lot of my roots experiences comes out of being with my grandmother in a single room occupancy, where you share bathroom and kitchen with other families. And that our room was the closest to the restrooms, and that was because that was the cheapest rent, and the closer you were to the bathroom, the cheaper, and the farther was that the rent was higher. Very good, poor air quality. In the community, the roots, the tuberculosis, my father had tuberculosis, I had a slight case of tuberculosis as a child, mental illness, drug addiction, and other things in terms of the legacy of growing up in a space where it was very well known in our family that if you lived, you moved outside of that space, that you could be beat up or killed. And my mother would talk often of walking home and walking over dead bodies to get home. So being also with my grandmother in the garment factories and early lessons in terms of class struggle and understanding the boss and the workers and also the oppression of women. So this was a lot in terms of my foundation. So during the 60s and the 70s, with the turmoil and great, how do I say, rebellions that were going on the campuses and in the streets of our communities across the country, and also the national liberation struggles. Those were moments that really started to reach out to me. And I wanted to say how I came to the movement. Well, the movement embraced me and hugged me. And that hug, in terms of understanding the resistance of the people and the power of the people, felt really good. And so the movement embraced me, and in return, I embraced the movement. And I'll talk a little bit more later about different concrete things, but when I want to talk about the movement, there are many movements that keep embracing me. And so it was the community, it was the student, it was the labor movement, it was the environmental movement. It's an ongoing embrace. The other is that I want to say is the movement for social justice was there, but also the left movement was there. And am I over my time?
No, you're up.
Oh, thank you. Because I tend to go off. So I want to talk about in terms of I'm also the product of the left and how the left was represented for me real clarity of people working together collectively to understand how the world is functioning and what is the root causes of the conditions in which our people need to resist and need to be resilient in. And so that embrace I want to just share with me is that the left was a movement that really reached out and connected to me, made the world relevant to me, forced me to understand and be critical, to develop my analysis skills, but also to learn and to understand how to work with others, to look at problems, see a problem and figure out we need to do this collectively together and go out there and do it and we win. That's cool. Come back, reflect, learn from it, go out there, analyze, go out there and go and continue the fight. And so the left for me was a very strong embrace and that is has played a very strong role.
That's really great. Thank you, Pam.
So Pam, you passed the mic, but we're not quite done with you yet. We are going to come back to this question of the left, because I think it winds up playing an important role in both yours and Steve's movement histories. But I mean, most people in this room probably know that if you look down Pam's resume, there's like a long list of founder of Chinese Progressive Association. She was a member of the organizations that were fighting one of the first fights against gentrification in San Francisco against the displacement of the people at the I Hotel. Pam was one of the founders of the environmental justice movement. movement. Like, just sort of going down the list, there are these incredibly rich experiences that you've had. And I was hoping that you could maybe tell a story about something that was really formative in your early career as an organizer and an activist.
Sure. I was on campus in Hayward. I was sitting in this class meeting, and it was called, and I remember this is back in the 60s, called the Orioxy Club, Oriental Occidental Club. And it was my first meeting, and I just sat there, and I was just listening, and a woman came in to that meeting. And she talked about the struggle for ethnic studies, no, the struggle for Asian studies on UC campus as part of the ethnic studies struggle, but talked about the purpose of the struggle for ethnic studies in which I came to understand is to challenge the Eurocentric education that we're getting on campus and the white supremacy in terms of the education that was instilling, and that it was really important for us in this fight to go back to community, to go to serve the community. And so she asked for volunteers to go to community and return to community. And I was like, okay, where are we talking about? San Francisco, Chinatown. Oh, okay. And so I and another guy raised our hands and we signed up. A week later, and this is really important, organizers, a very short time later, I got a phone call talking to me and saying, you signed up for this, we'd like you to show up at this place on Kearney Street in the area of Manila Town, Chinatown. And it's in the International Hotel. I said, okay, I'll go. And it was a life-changing moment. But what I want to say with this was, it was the ask. When I said that I was embraced by the movement, I was asked by the movement to come, the ask. And I accepted. Now, when I went there, I participated in one of the first things was with the Asian Legal Service draft help, and volunteered and to answer the phones there. And then I went upstairs and joined the movement to stop the evictions of the International Hotel, stop the encroachment of Wall Street West, to gobble up Manila Town, Chinatown, to stop the developers who deliberately messaged that Kearney Street block and down to California was a slum, right, that needed to be gotten rid of, and that developer was Walter Shorensky. So I was a part of that fight, and I want to explain, being part of the International Hotel struggle is a very important moment in my life. Why? It wasn't just going to a meeting, right, and talking and saying they're going to go to an action. The International Hotel brought students together with the Manons to live side by side, to recapture and learn the history of our people, the struggle of our people, the resilience of our people, and it also put a paintbrush in my hand, where on the third floor, which was a result of an arson, was burned out, and we went room to room and repaired and brought that hotel to life, back to life. It was the fight and a policy to City Hall and challenge, and it was the organizing to stop the eviction, where I became part of the tactical crew to be there on the night of the eviction, and I was in the front lines with thousands of other people when the sheriff came to evict us.
The picture of Pam and that blockade is right there, the bottom right.
And the sheriff coming at us six different times. I want to share this with people. I was tactical. I was right there, right in the front, like two rows from the horses. when each time they came, people were bloodied by the sheriff. I was not hit once. And it was because people knew I was tactical, was making decisions there, and each time the sheriff came with us with the clubs, people covered me and made sure I was okay and protected me. And I was never hit once. And when I got up, I saw all of these people that was bloody. Am I finished? Can I have one more thing? So what I want to say is, what is a victory? The International Hotel was a victory because it built a movement. We brought people together, thousands and thousands of people. It was a space where with the storefronts and spaces was art and culture, political debate, organizing, bonding, developing of relationships. It was a powerful moment that we need to be able to recapture again, because Facebook doesn't do that. Relationships and being with each other does that, right? And being with the manongs and the intergenerational spaces that are provided. So that is a victory. The night we lost, okay, the 300 tenants were evicted, but you go to that block today, we won because the insurance didn't get that land. Did Wall Street get that land? No. We have a community college there. We got a school there. We've got the iHotel there with housing that is safe for the community, with community space on the bottom, with fresh air. And when the tenants go upstairs, there's an open roof garden. I want that for all of Chinatown. I want that for all of our people. And that's the victory. We lost that night, but the capitalists didn't win.
I hope it was going to be a good night. One of the things for me is just always incredible to get a chance to hear Pam and Steve tell these stories about the 60s and 70s, and thinking that, you know, at that point in time I was watching Sesame Street. But in some very important ways, there is this history and legacy of struggle all around the globe, but even here in San Francisco, going back to the general strike, fast forwarding to the iHotel, and in some very important ways, that history has been broken for a lot of young people, and it's really important for us to have the opportunity to be able to reconnect to that, not just as historical episodes, but also as experiences that our ancestors, that our elders participated in, and that we get to continue the legacy of. So, thank you.